to teach you how to name geometric figures, specifically point, line, and plane. Now, a point is very easy to name. They just assign a letter to it. There's point A, there's point B. Very simple. But a line is a set of points that is going in opposite directions. Now, there's three points on there, but you use any two points on the line. You can name it line AB, or you could use a little symbol on top of there. The order doesn't matter. It could be BA, AC, CA, BC, or CB. Any two points. Don't use three, don't use one. Well, what about line segments? Well, segment is just a part of a line. It doesn't keep going on forever, so there's no little arrows. Now, this segment here could be called line segment AB, or you could just use a little symbol on top of there. And again, the order doesn't matter, so it could be BA, but you have to name it with those end points. Now, that's going to be BC or CB, those two endpoints, or the whole line segment could be AC or CA. Just use the endpoints. Planes can be a little more complicated. Now, here we're going to have a plane, a set of points making up a two-dimensional surface. And see that R right there does not represent a point. We can name the entire plane plane R. It's going to be cursive if they're going to do that. You could also use any three non-collinear points, like plane ABC. Non-collinear means they don't make a straight line. I'll explain that later. But again, the order doesn't matter. It could be BAC or CBA, no big deal. Let's go ahead and try again. Now, this plane could be named plane M, but it also has five little points on there. We're going to use those to go ahead and name it. Again, that's plane M. Here, what can we name the plane if all the arrangements, all the different orders of the same three letters are treated as one name? Well, let's go ahead and just go in order. Let's go PQR. It could be named plane PQR, just use the symbol. But I'm going to write all the ways that you could start with just the letter P, and I'll go in order. So, we'll go PQS and then PQT. Well, that's all the ones with PQ, so I go to R. PRS and PRT. Using that order makes it much simpler. Well, I'm done with R, I move on to S. PST. Those are all the ones that would begin with P. Well, what about all the ones that could begin with Q if I'm going in order? I'll go QRS and then QRT. And then go with the S, I'm done with the R, go QST. So those are all the ones that are left over that begin with Q. What about all the ones that begin with R if I'm still going in order while I only have the S and the T left? So if you go in order, you can find all the different combinations. So now let's get back to that idea of three non-collinear points. Why can't I name this plane ABC? Well, the reason for that, they make a straight line, and you can draw a lot of different planes, an infinite number of planes, that will also go through ABC. Plane N could be called ABC, or plane M could be called ABC. I could draw another plane that goes through it that's ABC. It wouldn't make any sense, so always pick three non-collinear points. And remember that N and M are not points, and you have to use three, not four, not two points.